Graduation ceremony for our second intake. First, we would like to welcome Professor Laila Skander, Professor Dr. Sheikh Ahmed, Professor Dr. Hussein Issa, Dr. Johansson Aid, Dr. Hassan Ghazar is not there yet, Thomas Engelhardt, Roman Luxheider from the ALA, and Professor Dr. Tagadi for attending and honoring us with your attendance. We'd like to have some address notes right now. So first, we'll start with Professor Hussein Issa.
Professor Dr. Laila Skander, State Minister of Urban Renewal and Informal Areas. Professor Dr. Sharif Hamad, Minister of Scientific Research. Professor Dr. Johansson Aid, Head of National Authority for Quality Assurance and Accreditation of Education. Mr. Thomas Engler, Head of GIZ Cairo Office. Dr. Roman Lechester, Head of the IUSD Cairo Office. Dr. Saeed Tagadeen, Head of the Central Department for Cultural Affairs and Missions. It's my pleasure to be here to celebrate second intake of MSc Integrated Urbanism and Sustainable Design, which we are honored in Hanshams University to have this degree in cooperation with Stuttgart University. And I know that we start intake number 5 or 6, and this course, this program is one of our successful programs in Hanshams University, and we're always honored with this program, and it's proof that Egyptian universities could be global university and international universities and can make a good effective cooperation with other European universities. Thank you so much for this good celebration, and I would like to congratulate the graduates of this intake, and I wish best luck for our students. Thank you so much.
We'd like to welcome Dr. Laila Skander now to the stage, please.
It's a real pleasure to be partners with you here at Hanshams University and the Ministry. For us, it's a very important partnership because we have a long way to go. The program is called Integrated and Sustainable Design. We in the Ministry consider that we can claim it's integrated when everybody in the city has become integrated, not when we have built up an environment that is nice and neat and clean for everybody. We have a long way to go, and so we hope our partnership is solid and strong. It will be sustainable when the lives of people are decent, are human, their livelihoods are enough to make them live decent lives, their education is such that they can make a dent in their communities and in the country. So, I want you to know we're bombarded every day with emails, all of us. I have with me Dr. Sharif Al-Ghahri from the ministry, from people all over Cairo, all over Egypt, who tell us the solution to slums is to move everybody out of the city, because now it's land that has very high value, move them out to the desert, clear the land for high investment, and find something for these people to do. So we have a long way to go. Who's going to explain things to people? We do our best, but we can't do it alone. We rely on the university. It's the beacon of education. It's the beacon of reaching people with ideas and with changing mindsets and with connecting the two sides of the wall. Arafan tried to do it. They succeeded somewhat. We're hoping that Ayn Shams University will help us through this program and others to bridge the gap between the people who live in slums and the people who think that they should be removed out of slums, thrown into the desert somewhere, and invest in land. So thank you very much for coming into this partnership with us, and let's do it together. Thank you.
If we can welcome now Dr. Sheikh Ahmed.
Thank you all for coming to celebrate a new graduation for tens of students, tens of master theses contributing to Egypt and contributing to human society as a whole. Actually, I'm very happy today because it's been now 4 years, started by Dr. Hansen, Muhammad Salhin, Dr. Tuchi. It's been 4 years. We haven't seen this big success now, but actually this is a very long success story for Ayn Shams University and for Egypt. At that moment, 4 years ago, I haven't known at all what's meant by IUSD, Integrated Urbanism and Sustainable Development. But now it's not only understanding, but I live the meaning, and it's a high requirement on the government. My happiness actually is to see Dr. Laila with us today. This is a high proof of the success of this program, because all your ideas and all your thesis work will have a domain to apply in Egypt. From day one, you focused on the current nagging problems of Egyptians. And now, hopefully, we will see your solutions applied. Today, actually, we think of the whole meaning of integrated urbanism. It's not only building, but thinking of people, thinking of energy, thinking of water, thinking of communication, thinking of everything. So I'm very happy that it was a lucky day when I started with Dr. Tuchi and Ayn Shams University and started to know this important word, IUSD. So thank you very much indeed, and hope for all of you to enjoy this evening. Thank you very much.
Please welcome Dr. Roman Lukshider, the head of the DAD Cairo office.
Dear Excellencies, dear Professor Aisa, dear Professor Sahin, dear Professor Stockmann, ladies and gentlemen, I have so many numbers and names in my paper so that I have to read. It's a great pleasure for me to welcome here you all on behalf of the German Academic Exchange Service and to celebrate together the graduation of the IUSD second intake. In fact, we wish to congratulate you to have succeeded in one of the most prestigious master programs in the DAD funding program, with a total budget of approximately 2.7 million euro. The German Federal Ministry of Economic Cooperation and Development, the Federal Ministry of Education and Research, and the Egyptian Ministry of Higher Education jointly finance this Master of Science for the period from 2010 until 2017. Building up on an already developed partnership in the Tempus program, Stuttgart University and Ayn Shams University continued the successful cooperation on the common path to set up the IUSD master in difficult times. They filled it with life, ongoing discussions, intelligent and outreaching projects, and because of the great achievements in organization, technical, and communication matters, they have recently joined the GAMP network of the 5 bicultural master programs of the DAAD. I would like to acknowledge here especially Professor Mohamed Salim's and Professor Antje Stockmann's input and dedication. They are sitting there. I think without these two driving forces sitting there, we would not be here today and proudly celebrating the second generation of IUSD master students. Until today, the DAAD has awarded 84 scholarships to Egyptians, Germans, and many other nationals in the IUSD program, and in the selective process has nominated 9 scholarship holders, which were then fully financed by the Egyptian Ministry of Higher Education. We wish that this program has a long-lasting effect on its partners, on their confidence to develop further fruitful cooperation, on its students, and their personal relations among their fellows and their teachers, and on the understanding of both cultures. We consider IUSD students to be strong analysts and future decision makers, equipped with soft skills and creativity to cope with the challenges of the Egyptian, European, and global markets. I personally wish you a great career, but also hope that you stay connected, profit from our strong alumni network, by the way, and help this great IUSD master program to become sustainable and integrated into our two cultures. Thank you and have a nice evening.
Thank you. Please welcome to the stage Professor Antje Stockmann, the IUSD UStutt Director.
Dear Excellencies, dear partners of the IUSD program, dear parents of our students, dear IUSD family, and above all, of course, dear new graduates of our second generation of IUSD students. I'm so glad to be here tonight, in this wonderful evening, in this wonderful location, in a park, in the middle of Cairo, me being a landscape architect, our program being on the topic of integrated urbanism and sustainable design. And I think this location and this also events just fits perfectly what we are also talking about. It's so great that you, our ISD students, had the courage, the persistence, and also the resolve to join our master's program, which is not only, as it might already be difficult enough to get masters in one university and in one country, but it's actually studying 2 masters in parallel in 2 different locations, 1 year in Germany, 1 year in Egypt, and above all, not only that, but with this intake, who we are celebrating tonight, they also spent some time in Tunisia, with our partners and friends from Tunisia also being here with us tonight, who contributed also to the success of the program being held. Now, tonight, it's time to celebrate. I just want to tell a very short story that illustrates this. There are 2 small fish swimming along in the water and another older fish coming across from the other way. And he asked the 2 young fish, "Hey boys, good evening. How's the water?" The 2 young fish continue swimming, look at each other and ask, "What the hell is water?" This is often the question we ask ourselves. We are so indulged in our own way of life, in our environment, that it's really not so easy to become aware and to think about what seems to be completely obvious. And we only discover what water, what air, what environment, what architecture only means if we go deeper. And the surprising thing is, if we experience different countries, different cultures, different attitudes of different people that we live together with, that we shared experiences and thoughts, this is what helps us to reflect on our own way of thinking. The real value of education, from our point of view, has only very little to do with just gaining knowledge, because if you want to gain knowledge, there are so many books and it's so easy, actually, if you are interested in a certain topic, to gain the knowledge. It's really more about creating awareness of what's real, what is essential, which might be hidden in plain sight all around us. And we have to remind ourselves all the time, this is water, but how is the water? Where are we actually swimming? Where do we want to swim? It is unimaginably hard to stay conscious and alive. Tonight, you are becoming one of the IUSD alumni, the alumni of Stuttgart University, alumni of Einschams University, and alumni of DAD, as we just heard. And you are swimming out into the waters of the big world in all different countries and even continents. On behalf of our growing IUSD family, I wish you great happiness, all the luck in the world, and I sincerely hope we will stay connected wherever you go. We will continue sharing thoughts, and you are the ambassadors of IUSD. You are bringing its values out to the world, into the different communities that we are all serving. Live purposefully, with courage and passion. Be true to yourselves, and you will inspire others just as you inspired us. Congratulations and be happy.
Okay, thanks, Antia. Now we welcome Professor Dr. Mohammed Safheen, the Egyptian director for the program.
Well, welcome you all, dear ministers, dear president, dear board of the university, and dear friends. Those who know me quite well, I'm best at improvising. I'm not the best at preparing speeches. So my speech would be as short as that. Not really, these are just the points I'd like to talk about. It's about our experience in IUSD. Antia, as my partner, really in that program, covered a big part of what we both would like to share with you today. She shared with you what's the whole about for our students, but maybe I would like to share the other part, what it's all about for everybody else. What makes it, what makes IUSD a bit special? What makes it special for us? What makes it maybe special for others? Let's start from the beginning. Again, 4 years ago, we started, three professors, together, just thinking, having that call, and we just thought we'd just like to do something different. There was a call, and actually we did not follow the call, and we intentionally did not follow the call. Yes, yes, Dr. Roman, we'd like to tell you that we did not follow the call, and for us, we just don't want to win the call, but we just would like to win it as we would like it to be. So we put all of our hopes and maybe intuitions in that. And it was just like a gambling game. What how would it look like when we put a proposal that might go against the call of those who tendered the call? And it turns out quite well. Evaluators really liked it. And they thought we are already challenging enough that we challenge the call itself. So we're not only trying to follow the call, but we are not taking the right, only the norm or the path that has been drawn to us, but we are quite challenging. And that was the first. Then, winning. What does it mean? We got the official results. End of November 2010. Kickoff was 5th of December 2010. And we were supposed to start the program and making advertisement January 2011, if that means anything for anybody.
And during that time, I do remember on the 27th of January, having a phone call from Philip Misselwitz, our third partner. He's not anymore now in Stuttgart. He was in Stuttgart and said, Mohammed, we are now thinking about the acronym. We'd like to think about the acronym. I said, Philip, we have a lot of things to do than to think about the acronym. He said, yeah, but we have to also think about that and we have to develop it. To that extent, we were fully devoted that every detail we think about it, and I can't remember how many hours we spent on just the acronym of the program. Yeah, but then so many people with lots of enthusiasm and support joined. Dr. Johansson joined. The whole maybe university on both sides joined, and they supported initiating and pushing the program. Yeah, that was really a blessing from God that we had that support at the beginning, because it was really a difficult time. Okay, and then the team started to grow bigger and bigger on both sides. And I can't remember any single person of the team who worked not as a believer in what we're doing. None of us worked as just doing the business. We were just believers, and we would take ages to discuss because we'd like to make it better, better for us, better for the students, better for the society, and even better for our universities. So what came first afterwards is partners. We thought that only doing it in universities is not our cup of tea. We're not only an academic. We're not only working for the academia. We'd like to go for the industry, we'd like to go for the society, and we'd like to work with the society, we'd like to work with real people, real partners. We had lots of partners, and I have to tell you, and we spoke to them, we had support, and we had input. Governor Cairo, the Baden-Württemberg, you name it. I mean, we had something like 15 partners at the beginning, and we're still working. We just don't have partners to make our portfolio bigger of partners. But we only have the partners to support them and to support us and to make mutual benefit for both, for the society, to make what we're doing actually means anything for anybody. Then finally, but most importantly, comes the students. And I think we will always, at the beginning we thought that our first intake would always be special. But then we found our reasons why also our second intake is also special. And now we have also reasons why the third intake is also very special. And I think we will not stop, because each intake, we kind of try to make up reasons why each intake is special. And they all, each one of them, each one of you ISDNs, really actually have a place in our hearts and our minds. The first intake, they had the experience of building the program with us. And I'm stressing it. They were actually building the program with us. The second intake, I have to really, really thank them from the deepest of my heart for their support for the third semester in Tunis. I know it was not easy. It was not easy for us. It was not easy for you. And I'm really glad that you came out of that with some experience, I hope, with some things that you enjoyed as well. So thanks a lot for the second intake. And the third intake, they are also very special, because finally, we are being questioned. Now we have an evaluation committee coming to us, and we cannot take any excuses. We're playing on our playground, and we have support from everybody, so we have no excuses. So you are also special, the third intake, because we have no excuses, and I have to tell you that, so you can judge us against. The fourth intake started in Stuttgart, and it's also special. Why? It's the first intake that we include students from outside the MENA region and Germany. We have students from Latin America, we have students from Turkey, we have students from Ethiopia, we have students from a lot of other places from different parts of the world. That will definitely bring a different experience. I think it already started to bring different experiences. I think they already had their first Latin dancing party last week. So the Latin students, they already came in with their culture, which is, I think, quite interesting. So students, they don't only come with the culture, but they come with deep experience. Each and every student from our students, they come with their beliefs, they come with their intuition on how they would like to make things better. And I quote one or two, actually, of the students from the first intake whom I met in Tunisia. They are our graduates. And when I asked them about their jobs, they said, we cannot easily find jobs. I said, what are we going to say to the ADE? Because we are promising employment. And my worries got really released because they said, we are being offered jobs, but we don't like them. We are not now used to do things as business as usual. We question everything. We question the norms. We question what's being done on the daily business. We have our own values that we'd like to bring. And this only then that I felt again happy. And I think this is what ISDNs develop, not only knowledge, but attitude. Very critical attitude towards what could be mentioned as business as usual. They don't accept business as usual. And I have to tell you, we're having a hard time in teaching them. And maybe one of the ex-alumni, they're already with us, joined the teaching. And I think maybe she does not see me without saying, we're really sorry. We're really sorry for what we've done to you. And I think it may be a good thing to bring all of them in a teaching experience so that they know what they have done to us. But we're glad that we're bringing you that tough. So what's next? The next is in the hands of the ISDNs. We only here to facilitate things. We only here to make it possible for you to develop, to grow, to bring your ideas into reality. Let's just consider us as incubators, supporters, nothing more. We're just your brothers, sisters, and we're helping. We'll continue helping. It doesn't matter that you graduated last year or this year. Just come to us at any moment. We will always help. I think with support from ministries, today we will sign a protocol with the Ministry of Urban Renewal and Informal Settlements. And the reason for that, we'd like the work that's being done on ISD to be useful for the society, not just to be have it as an academic exercise. And we're signing a tough protocol. It's like really a tough job. And that's also to put pressure that we cannot just work for academia. It has to make use for society. We're also attracting projects from the Ministry of Scientific Research. We already got two from them. And we'd like that you all join in that. If you have ideas, just bring them in. We would like to make your ideas come true. We can even help you in your hometowns, in your countries. We're not only here to support you in Egypt. As you all know, we have some trips from time to time, and we have partners. So in brief, what I'm trying to say is ISD in Stuttgart and Ein Shams will remain your place. No matter when, just when you have an idea, just bring it in, have it as yours, and full support from ISD and partners. Thank you all for making it to this moment, for the great presentations and the great thesis and research work that you showed us. It's still possible with a Plan B. And all ISDNs know what Plan B is. Thank you very much. And thanks a lot for our great guest who honored us today coming. And I would like maybe specifically to thank my partners from Stuttgart, everybody from Stuttgart, and the team from Cairo. I have to tell you, it just takes a good team to do it. It cannot be otherwise. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, for the last speech of the night, we like to welcome to the stage Ayhem Dalal, the representative of the second stage.
Thank you, everyone. Dear Excellencies, dear colleagues, staff members, family, and friends of IUSD, tonight is a celebration of change. It's a great opportunity to finally be in Cairo after all the difficulties. And it's such an honor to speak on the behalf of my colleagues in Cairo and those in Stuttgart that could not make it here tonight. Sari, Abdurrahman, Sana, also Fadi and Lucas. And also Dina, who gave birth just 2 days ago. Dear friends, tonight we are here to celebrate our success and to cherish our memories, and for most to celebrate change. A smart person said once, never believe that a few caring people cannot change the world, for indeed that's all who ever have. Exactly around 2 years from now, a small group of students met for the first time in Stuttgart. Each has come from a different background, from a different culture, spoke a different language, and if not even a different dialect, lived a different life and had a different experience. At that moment, their journey of change began. And Stuttgart, Berlin, Venice, Darmstadt, Villefontaine, Tunis, Djerba, and Cairo, in every place they learned something new. While they were studying and traveling, they were exploring new cities and new spaces, new ideas, new cultures, and new mind-opening experiences. They met people and discovered new dimensions, and they laughed, they cried, they danced, they failed, they succeed together. Integration, urbanism, sustainability, and design. 6 months ago, each of the students had the chance to start their own small journey, to fight their own small battle. They tried to make a change. And I'm so proud to realize how much we developed and how much we grew throughout all the challenges we were facing. And tonight, this journey did not end. It has newly begun. For that, I'm truly thankful for the AAD, for the staff of Stuttgart University and the staff of Ein Shams University. Dear colleagues, in this very moment, I invite you to realize and celebrate the way we have been changed. We are changing, and we will change our environment. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Rahim. Okay, for the entertainment part of our ceremony, please welcome to the stage the Nubian Band of Kayan Foundation.
Bahari ngas keyo mentina, sigiri malawa yin.
First name, Daniel Koshak. That's for you. Eric. Ermitroyd. Katrina Freeling. Our next student is not present with us today, Abdulrahman. Ayham, can you get it? Can get his from Stuttgart. Athar? And you get the bag. Ayham, come this time for real. Tarek, can you join us? Next is Sana Kasuha, who's also not here, unfortunately. Ayham, please. You can go around. This is Sana. Noah Aneb. Hamad Mahrous. Muhammad Anis. Rasha. Rasha Abdul Salam. Mehmet.
Hamad Afay. Mossad. Usam Mansour. Albert Dis. Heba Badr. Next is Dean Abdul Rashid, and I think all of you heard she just gave birth 2 days ago. She Ayham again or Wissam? And last but certainly not least, Sarah Abdul Majid. Second intake graduates, would you come to the stage for a group photo? Can the IUSD staff come down here as well?